Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Rob Brock, and before I tell you what we have this month, just a quick reminder, there are still a few tickets left for QtDevCon in Berlin. We've extended the ticket sale just for a few more days. Ticket supply is limited though, so if you still want to join the conference, don't be late. Check out the agenda and get your ticket on qtdevcon.com. And here's what we do have in this edition. Lars Knoll stepping down as Qt Chief Maintainer. New version of Kuesa 3D, an interview with Timo Buske from KDAB, who is responsible for Kuesa. Qt speech is coming to 6.4. Tip of the month and announcements. First, some breaking news that became public last week. After 25 years at the helm, Lars Knoll announced that he will step down from his role as CTO at the Qt company and chief maintainer of Qt, although he will still be maintaining Qt Multimedia. After the summer, he will be joining a small Norwegian startup with one of the founders of Trolltech, whose work is not related to C++ nor developer tools. Much respected within the Qt community and a keynote speaker at Qt events since any of us can remember, his contribution to the success of the Qt project has been invaluable. We shall miss him. Farewell, Lars, and good luck for your new endeavor. In a few months, a new version of Kuesa 3D is to be released. To learn more about what Kuesa 3D actually is and what the new version will bring, I'm talking to the project manager, Timo Buske, today. Hi, Timo.
Hey, Robert. Thanks for having me here.
So, a quick reminder for our audience. Can you briefly explain what Kuesa does?
Yeah, sure. So, Kuesa is what you need to add 3D to your industrial application. And industrial is the keyword here, since we don't want to be just another game engine and we don't want to provide a huge all-purpose framework. We are focusing on just what you need, for example, to create an automotive cluster or to visualize a machine or so. So this comes with a big advantage, since Kuesa is lightweight and optimized. So it works with desktop and embedded.
Awesome. Thank you. There will soon be a new version of Kuesa. What would you say is new?
Yeah. So the biggest improvement is that Kuesa now supports Vulkan. So if you need an out-of-the-box Vulkan renderer, the hard work is already done for you. And due to the low levelness of Vulkan, we can use the hardware more efficiently. So this results, for example, in potentially higher frame rates or lower power consumption. And the second thing is, since we now have a custom renderer, Kuesa is not tied anymore to a specific framework. So if you have a 2D technology and your 2D technology is supporting Vulkan, you will be able to make this work with Kuesa. And we already have RML UI and IMG UI running nicely.
Nice. Something to look forward to. KDAB will show a preview demo at Embedded World. What will people be able to see?
Right. So we will be there with a new Kuesa demo. So if you want to see it live or check it out, then meet us at the Embedded World in Nuremberg and we'll be happy to show you how Kuesa works.
Excellent. Thank you. Hopefully we'll see you there.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
If you are interested to learn more, as mentioned, you can see a demo of Kuesa 3D at Embedded World in Nuremberg from the 21st to the 23rd of June. Also, keep your eyes open for the release, which is going to happen during the next few months. One of the modules that hasn't been available in Qt 6 yet will be coming soon. Over the last couple of months, the text-to-speech functionality in Qt Speech has been ported, and it will be part of the Qt 6.4 release later in 2022. Qt Speech provides application developers with a Qt object subclass, Qt text-to-speech, that offers an interface to the platform's speech synthesizer engine and a value type QVoice that encapsulates voice characteristics. With those classes, applications can make themselves more accessible to users and go beyond the screen reader functionality of assistive technologies. The APIs in the Qt Speech module are practically unchanged, and most Qt 5 applications that use Qt Text-to-Speech today will not have to make any code changes when moving to Qt 6. Learn more about supported engines, porting from Qt 5 to Qt 6, and the QML API in the blog post linked in the video description below. You have two choices when it comes to giving a custom style to your Qt widgets. Qt style sheets are very convenient for getting started, just a few CSS-like rules, and they work. It is our experience, however, that Qt style sheets create too much trouble, and a QStyle subclass gives a better solution in the long run. Our colleague, David Faure, created a useful chart comparing the two choices to show you why a QStyle subclass trumps QtStyle sheets. You can find the link up above and in the description below. Out of the usual schedule, Embedded World will happen from the 21st to the 23rd of June this year. Visit KDAB in Hall 4 at the Qt booth, and as usual, we'll be showing some great demos. You can find a list of this year's ones on the page linked here or below. Qt World Summit has been announced as a virtual event for the 9th of November. The call for papers is open until the 10th of June. Also in November, Meeting C++ will take place in Berlin and online from the 17th to the 19th. You can submit your talk until the 12th of June. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. I'll see you next time.